Welcome to another episode of Africa in 10 Minutes, where we bring to you the top business stories reported on Footprints to Africa this week. My name is Uchenna Okafor, and here are the headlines. Nigeria to further improve ease of doing business. Ralph Mopita appointed MTN South Africa's CFO. Tony Elumelu Foundation received 63,000 startup ideas in 2 years. Nigerian aviation sector records decline in business. Chinese Indians distort prices in Ghana's jewelry market. Ghana industries urged to consider mergers. Nigerian Senate kicks out executives' external loan requests. Outgoing Economic Commission for Africa's head honored for service to Africa. The Nigerian government has assured the business community of its commitment to improve the ease of doing business in the country. The government promised to address bureaucratic and other impediments to registering new businesses as part of efforts to encourage entrepreneurs and facilitate investment in the country. The Minister of Information and Culture, Alhaji Lai Mohammed, gave the assurance on Saturday at the 2016 Tony Elumelu Foundation Entrepreneurship Forum in Lagos. In tech news, MTN has appointed Ralph Mopita to the Group Chief Financial Officer and Executive Director position. Mopita has extensive experience in senior leadership roles in the financial services sector, having had a 16-year career at Old Mutual. He is currently Chief Executive of Old Mutual Emerging Markets. Mopita's appointment will take effect from April 3, 2017. Tony Elumelu Foundation has disclosed that it received about 63,000 startup ideas, out of which only 2,000 were selected since inception 2 years ago. The forum hosted almost 1,000 women and men from 54 African countries. Following the forum, each entrepreneur is eligible to receive up to $10,000 to implement their business plan. The two-day forum buzzed with energy as entrepreneurs shared and gained knowledge, built cross-border partnerships, and connected with investors and policymakers, fulfilling the goal of fostering innovation and collaboration between entrepreneurs from across Africa. Nigerian aviation recorded a decline in activity between the first half of 2016 and the second half of 2015, both in terms of numbers of travelers and aircraft, and the weight of cargo and mail moved, according to data from the Nigeria Bureau of Statistics. Related to the first half of 2015, both the total number of passengers and the number of aircraft declined. In addition, although cargo remained relatively stable over this period, mail movements recorded a large decline. Murtala Mohammed Airport in Lagos was the airport to record the most activity, accounted for 36.6% of domestic passengers, 70.3% of international passengers, 91.8% of cargo movements, and 58.8% of mail movements. In the minerals sector, the Chinese and Indian incursion into Ghana's jewelry market has created an unfair competition, affecting the businesses of local jewelry manufacturers. The jewelers stated that the dealers from China and India offer higher prices to the small-scale miners for their gold, causing the local manufacturers to also buy the gold at a price higher than the global market price. Ernestina Bottompen, the chairperson of the Federation of Ashanti Regional Goldsmiths and Jewelers, said the local jewelry manufacturers rely on small-scale miners for their raw materials, but have been recently pushed away by the Indian and Chinese businessmen who are buying the minerals at prices higher than the global market price. James Ashari Aji, president of the Association of Ghana Industries, has urged local industries to partner both foreign and local to enhance their technical capacity. Mr. Ashari Aji maintained that more Ghanaian businesses will be in the position to take on big projects if they build their capacities to match international standards. He stated that building the capacity of local industries will also help them to be competitive and profitable. In other news, a request by Nigeria's executive arm led by President Muhammadu Buhari has been kicked out by the Nigerian Senate during Tuesday's plenary. President Buhari had formally requested approval from the National Assembly to borrow $29.96 billion from foreign sources to augment a shortfall in estimated revenue to fund development plans. The Red Chamber did not give any reason for rejecting the request as it was thrown out through a voice report. The Ministry of Foreign Affairs has honored Carlos Lutz for his role in promoting the development of Ethiopia and Africa at large. The outgoing Executive Secretary of the United Nations Economic Commission for Africa was with the UN for 8 years. He is largely acknowledged for his intellectual contribution to Africa's development agenda through bold thinking and fearless interventions. Lutz was presented with a certificate by the Ethiopian State Minister for Administrative Matters. That wraps up this week's top stories. We'll be back with a recap of the headlines. Nigeria to further improve ease of doing business. Ralph Mopita appointed MTN South Africa's CFO. Tony Elumelu Foundation received 63,000 startup ideas in 2 years. Nigerian aviation sector records decline in business. Chinese Indians distort prices in Ghana's jewelry market. Ghana industries urged to consider measures. Nigerian Senate kicks out executives' external loan requests. Outgoing Economic Commission for Africa's head honored for service to Africa. To keep up with the trending business news of the week, subscribe to our YouTube channel, like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter, and connect with us on LinkedIn. These news and reports are called from Footprint to Africa. For daily updates and more business news in Africa, visit www.footprinttoafrica.com today. Footprint to Africa, business news made in Africa by Africa.